In 2024, the bloc's membership doubled as its founding members, Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa, were joined by Egypt, Iran, the United Arab Emirates and Ethiopia. All have one thing in common, they're not part of the Western world, although many maintain close trade ties there. President Vladimir Putin says BRICS member countries are the drivers of global economic growth.
The total GDP of the BRICS Association is more than $60 trillion, and the total share in the global gross product confidently exceeds that of the so-called G7 countries and continues to grow.
Russian authorities are keen to promote the idea of a unified BRICS financial system to rival the dominant US dollar. More than 30 countries have expressed interest in joining BRICS. Their representatives will head to Kazan to participate in the extended BRICS Plus format. Others, however, are in no hurry to join. Russia's ally Kazakhstan says it has no plans to seek membership in the near future. Its president, though, promised to attend the gathering.
Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan is also expected to attend. Turkey has submitted a formal application to join BRICS, and with the Middle East settlement on the summit's agenda, Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas was also invited to Kazan.
That invitation came directly from President Putin, who has reaffirmed Russia's support for a two-state solution to the conflict.
BRICS has been making a lot of noise lately as a potential game-changer in global economics and politics, and this year, all eyes are on the upcoming BRICS Summit, set to take place in Kazan, Russia. What makes this year's summit particularly interesting? According to Russian President Vladimir Putin, over 30 countries have shown interest in joining BRICS. That's right, nations from all over the world are lining up to be part of this growing coalition, and it's bound to send shockwaves through the Western-led global order. So why are so many countries eager to join BRICS? And could this group really be the future of the world economy? Let's dive into what's driving this surge in interest and why BRICS is seen as such a powerful force on the global stage. Well, first, BRICS countries are steadily emerging as economic heavyweights on the global stage. Together, they account for over 40% of the world's population and nearly a quarter of global GDP. That's a huge chunk of the global economy, and the growth of these countries shows no signs of slowing down. China and India, for example, have become economic powerhouses in their own right. China has been the world's second largest economy for years now, and India is expected to overtake Japan to become the third largest economy by the end of this decade. Compare this to traditional Western economies like the US and Europe, which are growing at much slower rates. While developed economies are grappling with aging populations and slower innovation, BRICS countries, especially India and Brazil, have younger populations and growing middle classes. In fact, the middle class in BRICS countries is expected to double by 2030, creating a massive market for goods, services, and investment opportunities. This shift in economic momentum could redefine global trade routes and business strategies as companies increasingly look toward BRICS nations as the future of global growth. Secondly, this grouping is seeking to move away from the dollar. One of the boldest moves BRICS is making is its effort to reduce the world's reliance on the US dollar, a process called de-dollarization. Currently, most global trade, from oil to electronics, is conducted in dollars. This gives the US an enormous amount of power. Countries need dollars to trade, and the US can impose sanctions or restrict access to its financial systems if it doesn't like another country's policies. But BRICS countries want to change that by promoting trade in their local currencies. Russia and China, for example, have been particularly active in this space. After facing economic sanctions from the West, Russia started pushing for more trade in rubles and yuan. China, meanwhile, has struck deals with countries like Saudi Arabia to buy oil using the Chinese yuan instead of dollars. If successful, these moves could weaken the dominance of the dollar in global trade, giving countries more financial independence from the US. As of 2023, Trade between BRICS countries in local currencies has already risen significantly, with China-Russia trade in yuan up by 80% since the start of sanctions against Russia. If more countries adopt similar strategies, it could change the way international trade is conducted. Since the end of World War II, global financial systems, international trade rules, and even political alliances have been largely shaped by Western powers. The IMF and the World Bank, two key global financial institutions, are headquartered in Washington, and the US has significant sway in both. This often leaves developing countries, especially in the global South, feeling like they don't have enough of a voice in global decision-making. One of the key strengths of BRICS is its geopolitical flexibility, which makes it appealing to a wide range of countries. Unlike rigid alliances like NATO or the European Union, BRICS doesn't force its members to follow a strict set of political or economic policies. Instead, it allows each country to maintain its own foreign policy while still collaborating on issues like trade, development, and global governance. This flexibility allows members to pursue their national interests while also benefiting from collective influence. For example, BRICS includes countries with vastly different political systems, ideologies, and foreign policy approaches. China is a one-party state, while India is the world's largest democracy. Russia has its own geopolitical ambitions, while Brazil and South Africa focus more on development and regional leadership. Despite these differences, the BRICS nations are able to come together to address mutual concerns, like reforming global financial institutions or enhancing South-South cooperation. This loose structure is especially attractive to countries that want to be part of a global coalition but don't want to be locked into alliances where they might lose their autonomy. Furthermore, BRICS offers a platform for countries to challenge Western dominance without taking a hard stance against the West. Members don't have to align themselves against the US or Europe to benefit from being part of BRICS. This makes it easier for countries to navigate their foreign policy choices without burning bridges with traditional Western allies. In fact, many BRICS countries continue to engage with Western institutions like the IMF and World Bank, while also advocating for reforms that would give more power to emerging economies. So what's your take on this? Do you think BRICS is the future and could shake things up on the global stage? We'd love to hear your thoughts. Drop a comment below. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel to stay updated and show your support.